go a little bit more in depth on that smoothing brush. Now, if I hold down Shift and I have my smooth brush and it has Sculptors Pro mode turned on and it's orange, what I can do is I can make a big brush and that'll go ahead and smooth and get rid of all these details. However, let's say I wanted to smooth, but I didn't want to lose any tessellation in my geometry. So I'm gonna hold down Shift. Well, I'm gonna turn off Sculptors Pro mode, and now when I hold down Shift, I can just kind of soften these transitions in between objects. Now there's a couple options with the smooth brush. In ZBrush 2018, if you hold down Shift and you start smoothing and then you let go of Shift, it'll actually turn into an inflate. And that's useful for like if you have the snake hook here and you're pulling out long thin shapes with Sculptors Pro mode turned on, and then you hold down Shift and let go of Shift, it'll actually inflate for you. So that can kind of come in handy. But if we turn Sculptors Pro mode off and you're holding down Shift to smooth, then you're going to see as I'm trying to smooth these things, these shapes out here, I'm having to smooth a lot. And that's because through here, this geometry is pretty high. And it's also pretty uneven. Now, one way I could even this out is Z-remeshing and projecting, which we'll get to in a bit. But for now, what I want to do is just give my smooth brush a little bit more power. One way I can do that is I can hold down Shift, and that turns it to the smooth brush. I can go down here to the bottom of the brush menu. There's smooth brush modifiers here. There's a weighted smooth mode. If you hover over this, you're going to see, there's a bunch of different ones you can choose from. If you hold that control, it'll give you even more information. Basically, if you change this weighted smooth mode to 1, it becomes smooth stronger. So if I hold down Shift and then start smoothing, you're going to see my smooth brush has a lot more of an effect on the underlying surface. So I can go through here and smooth stronger. Now, because I was using Sculptors Pro mode and the surface is very uneven, one thing I can do to even this out is I can go to Tessimate and I can change this polygon size. If I change it down, it's going to Tessimate my entire surface here. Or if you want to, you can go back into your DynaMesh and you can just turn on DynaMesh and DynaMesh your object and get nice even geometry all over the place. And of course, you can change your resolution to get as much as you can. Another thing I like to do in DynaMesh is turn down this blur to 0 and then DynaMesh. So now when I go in here and smooth, you see I have a smooth weighted mode to 1 and now I'm smoothing stronger. And if I'm smoothing too strong, what I can do is I can hold down Shift, change that Z intensity down, and now I can start smoothing and it's less of a has less of an effect. So I like smooth weighted stronger better than the regular smooth brush, because I can smooth really strong, or I can just drop the Z intensity down and put it into like normal smooth mode. So it just gives me a broader range of smoothing. If you want, if you hit the comma key here, you go into brushes and then into smooth, you're gonna see we have a lot of smooth brushes in here, and there's like smooth perpendicular, smooth valance, and there's even a smooth stronger in here. So you can double click this and that'll make it your new smooth brush. If you notice some of those look familiar, if you go down here to the hold down, you don't have to hold down Shift, but the weighted smooth mode for your smooth brush modifiers, you're going to see there's number 2 is valance, number 5 is perpendicular. So as we change these weighted smooth modes, it actually goes through, and this is what they saved out: smooth perpendicular, smooth valance. They're just changing that weighted smooth mode for those brushes. But really, what I wanted to talk to is that smooth stronger option. I tend to find myself using that more than just regular smooth. And if you go back to the brush saving video, you know that you can, if you change your smooth brush to smooth stronger, you can hold down Shift and you can save this brush out, or any brush settings that you did, you can do brush save as, and you can save it as a Z startup brush so that it'll show up every time you start up ZBrush or into a folder. So go check that video out if you want to know more on that. Now let's talk about the ninth smooth brush modifier that's been introduced to ZBrush. In order to demonstrate this, we're going to have to do a little bit of work. I'm going to go into my brush palette here and we're going to choose just a Polymesh 3D, drag it out on my canvas, go into edit mode, go down here to initialize, and we're going to choose QQ. But first, what we're going to do is we're going to take this resolution, we'll type in like 16 and then hit tab 16, tab 16, enter, and then we'll go ahead and make a Q cube. Turn on polyframe and you can see we have a nice Q cube with polygroups on all different polygroups on all sides here. If you're not sure about that, go to polygroups and then just hit group by normals, and that'll go ahead and give you based on your normal angle different polygroup. So what you can do now, if you go down here, for instance, let's go to masking, and you can mask by just groups border. So you can do mask by feature groups border. And then I'm going to go down here to our deformation menu, and we're going to go over here to noise. I'm just going to run a noise right through that. So you're going to see we masked the corner. So those are going to stay put. Those are going to stay nice and sharp, but we've got noise all over the rest of this box. So let's say we want to keep these corners nice and sharp, but we want to smooth the rest of these features out. If I hold down Shift and smooth, you're going to see it's going to average all of the vertices underneath that smooth brush. Go down here to, oops, not modifiers, smooth brush modifiers. But way at the very end is number 9, which is Groups intersection. If you hold down control, that'll give you a little bit more information on all of the smooth modes, but we're going to focus on the groups intersect. So this is going to smooth the surface in between polygroups, but leave the edges alone between these polygroups. So with that option enabled, when I hold down shift, you're going to see, make sure you hold down shift and then change the weighted smooth mode to 9 on your smooth brush. And now when we hold down shift, it's going to have the weighted smooth mode set to 9. So when we start smoothing, it's going to leave those border edges in between the surfaces nice and crisp. It's going to go ahead and protect them. If we change this weighted smooth mode, say to 1, which is smooth stronger, again, it's going to, it's going to just totally just smooth in between them. Now you can go into auto masking and you can hold down shift and say mask by polygroups up to 100, and that will ignore other polygroups, but you're going to see it is going to still smooth that green polygroup, which is going to average it, and it's going to kind of melt it right in there. So it's going to technically leave the other polygroups alone, but it is going to drag those other vertices with it. So if you do truly want to leave those border edges alone, number one, you could go in here to mask by features and then just sit there and smooth if you want to. But if you want to do it just with your brush, make sure you hold down shift, go down here to the smooth brush modifiers, change that weighted smooth mode to 9 with shift selected, and then now it's just going to leave your polygroup borders alone. And you're going to see as I'm smoothing on this purple one and I go over here to the green, it's not going to do anything to the green because I still have mask by polygroup set to 100. If I turn that down, now it'll leave the polygroup borders alone and I can move across polygroups as needed. Something that'll come up with a smooth brush every once in a while. Let's grab a sphere 3D, drag it out, go into edit mode, make polymesh 3D, hold down control shift, and just grab a section of the sphere, go ahead and do geometry, modify topology, delete hidden. And if you go in here and you smooth, you hold down shift and you start smoothing, you're gonna see the smooth brush isn't gonna affect these outside pieces right here. Occasionally as well, you'll be using ZBrush and you'll get kind of a stray vert that goes out into space here and you'll try to smooth it down. It's working in this case. Sometimes it's a little bit more difficult. And in this case, it's because it has more connected points, but sometimes you'll get like, again, just like a stray vert that you can't smooth back no matter what you try. So if you go over to your brush options, go down to the smooth brush modifiers. We've already talked about the weighted smooth mode, but you also see a little min connected right here. If you drop that down to 1, now when you hold down shift to smooth, you can actually smooth these a lot easier. Now, if this does happen occasionally, which it does, sometimes what I'll do is I'll hold down control shift and alt, and then just delete it, and then I'll re-dynamesh, or I'll run a geometry, modify topology, close holes, and just start there, like if it happens when I'm dynameshing. I also want to mention in here, if you hit B, S to go to your smooth brushes in ZBrush 2021, by default, there's a smooth cloth option. So if I say OK, and then hold down shift, I have smooth cloth selected. And just like we talked about before, under the smooth brush modifiers, that min connected will be set to 1. So if you don't feel like setting your default smooth brush to be min connected, you can just grab, again, B, S, O, and grab that smooth cloth brush.